shall wear a crown. I shall wear a crown. When it's all over, when it's all over, I shall wear a crown, I shall wear a crown, when it's all over, when it's all over, I shall see his face. One day we're all gonna see his face. I shall see his face. His face, his face. Oh, when it's all over, when it's all, I shall see his face. Oh, 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 oh. I shall see his face. I'm gonna see his face when it's all over. Oh, when it's all.
Then you find recorded these words. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord. Amen. The word of God for the people of God.
I want to go to the moon. Don't leave so soon. Don't leave so soon. How can I keep going?
Strapping we up. Never forget all the memories.
Sitting, I sit by my cup,
thinking I should be a better me.
Truly I'm blessed from the start.
So much to say in these melodies.
Stare at the sky, the moon singing sweet.
Oh my God, such a sweet moment. Angels, they say I'm not ever weak. Such a lonely boy.
Heaven knows I might never sleep.
Trouble in my soul. Hey, I've been praying. Life can be training. Oh, hey, we're late. Try and keep falling. Oh,
I'm ashamed.
Hated what I will see. And nobody knows.
So I go.
Get through to the moon,
early afternoon.
Go to the moon,
take you to the moon. Go ahead, brother.
Yeah, I'm Greg Giles. I'm next to the oldest. And this was very a high appeal. It's been a high appeal for me today, man, since I'm not gonna ever see my brother again in the flesh, but I'm always gonna see him in the spirit. And I just thank God for him, cause he carried us all, me, myself, personally, all the way to 62 years. So that had to be good leadership. That's good leadership right there. I mean, you don't find too many of them doing that, you know, training their brothers and sisters and them up. He brought all of us in our 50s and 60s. Oh man, he was a real great blessing to us, you know. And he's gonna be well missed. Gonna be well missed. You know, I can go on and on and on and tell you the story of his life. Cause we stayed in the same house, we grew up together. He know me, I know him. We weren't just brothers, but we were best friends as well. So, you know, and we got, man, I just can't. I'm just gonna let God have his way, because these kind of situations right here, you had to take your situation to a great leader. And Chucky was a real great leader to all of us. He was a great leader.
my uncle, I heard a story where I was a teenager and he had this blue van, and he picked me up in the van, or I see him coming, I get in his van, I always ask to drive. He said, "You want to drive?" I'm like, "Yeah." He's like, "You already washed it for me." You know? And then like, we'd be riding around listening to, you know, Houdini and Curtis Blow, and I'm like, "Man, this music sucks." But as I'm used to listening to it now, I kind of, yeah, you know, see why he liked it so much. My uncle was one of a kind, man, and I'm gonna miss him. Man.
What you gonna miss the most?
I'm gonna miss him. Man. He's always tell me how proud he was of me. Especially when I left here, when I left home and went to the military. You know, every time that he just let me know how proud he was. You know, and even now. A few years, when I leave out, when I come back, he'll be like, "Yo, hey, nephew, just stay gone. Come back, do what you're doing, come back, visit, and then go back home." So, man, it's rough. I'm gonna miss him, man. He made me proud to be at Giles. He's always said how important our name was, because we didn't have many males with the Giles last name. There's only a few of us. He always made me proud to be a Giles. To this day, I instill that into my sons. I got three boys. And I'm gonna make sure that they know, you know, where they came from. Chuck.
I tell you one thing about Chuck. He always showed me how to carry myself as a man. No matter what you're going through, you stand straight up, shoulders back, and whatever's coming your way, take your head on. One thing I used to remember about him, he used to get upset. "You two, come here, get over here." He used to say it so fast, I can't even say it. Maybe he can, I can't. They talk that fast. But, you know, when we got older, you know, we went to the military, we would come back, and I would come back periodically. When he came back, we would kind of catch up together, he'll be around. He would always tell both the boys, "I know you two is gonna do something. Make some money, sales, we're gonna do good for yourselves." And he just would tell us to keep it up. And you know, as far as being in when I went in the military, I came back around, like he said, it seemed like he was so proud that, you know, he kind of raised us, so to say. And he was proud. You know, we made him happy, so which made me happy. Everything is all good. We miss you, Uncle Chuck. Keep writing. You know what time it is.
want to say, Granddad, you are a wonderful man, one of the first men that I ever knew, like, growing up. You know, taught me a lot of things. You put me in my first basketball, you know, Park District. You did a lot of things for me growing up. We had a wonderful relationship, man. And some things, you know, can't ask for, but, you know, I know I had a great granddad. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to thank you for everything you've done for me to the time I was born, all the way until now. And I hope you rest in peace.
Loving, kind brother, and he loved music. His favorite R&B group was The Whispers and James Brown and Marvin Gaye. And so, you know, we always looked up to Chucky as a kid when he was our older brother. He was loving, kind, caring, and he'd do anything for anybody. He was a people person and a fun person to be around. And he loved family gatherings, like barbecues, the Thanksgiving, Christmas. You know, he was just the joy of the family. And every time he come into a room, he lights up the room with a big smile.
Yes, Uncle Chucky, we'll miss you so much. You are just so fun-loving. Gonna miss your smile, laughter, and joy that you always brought to the family. We love you so much. We know that you're now in heaven, and God is taking care of you now, but we know that you're here watching over us now as well. We love you so much. We'll miss you forever, and just know that you'll forever be our life of the party. Love you.
Love you, brother. Love you forever.
Yes.
One more thing. What you gonna miss the most?
I'm gonna miss his smile. He calls me on Sundays and say, "Hey, big sis, what's up? What you cooking?" Because he loved to eat. He loved food.
And for me, I'm just gonna miss his laugh. Like, he would always just bring so much joy with his laughter. He would have just the funniest jokes to tell, and he was just amazing. I'm gonna miss that.
And he called you baby girl.
Oh yes, we'll never forget that. Always had the best nicknames to give.
Yes. My name is Crystal Giles. Chucky Giles, baby girl. I'll start by saying without him, I wouldn't be here, clearly. Takes two. But I just want to say that I do appreciate the good times more than ever. Out of any other time, it was the good times. You know, I love you no matter what, and I know you love me no matter what. I swear you love me so much, even when I ain't want to show it, you still show me love when I ain't want to show it to you. And I appreciate that. And I thank you so, so very much, Chucky, for waiting for me. You waited for me, and I know you waited for me, because you didn't say no more after you saw me. And I thank you for that. And I love you always. Your baby girl, Crystal. The last thing you said to me, your baby girl. So I thank you for waiting for me, and I love you. I'm gonna miss you, dear. And just rest easy.
I'm gonna say that I'm blessed to have one of the coolest, realest pops that a son, especially an older son, asked for. I'm so glad I got your smile, Dad. Sometimes I got your personality when I'm not being an introvert, but you taught me so much, and I'm gonna truly miss, you know, calling you and talking to you, man. That's what's gonna hurt the most, man. Like, a night like tonight, if this is somebody else, man, that I can call you, and you gonna, if I'm too emotional, you gonna check me. You know, you're gonna tell me, don't get off your square. You know, you're gonna tell me, keep my head up. And I'm gonna sleep better tonight knowing that I talked to my father. So I ain't gonna keep it long, man, but I'm gonna miss you. I love you. And I'm so glad that I'm a Giles, and I stand proud of being a Giles. Because of Richard Chucky Giles. I'm gonna love you forever, Dad, and I'm gonna always tell your grandkids, and we're gonna always tell stories about you, man. And I'm gonna miss your storytelling. I'm gonna try to hold on to the tradition and keep it going. You know, but you're gonna be missed, and I love you forever. That's all I got.
Yeah, I'm gonna hold nobody up, but yeah, I just wanted to say, of course, I'm gonna truly miss my father. He was a good father, a good uncle, a good sibling, brother, a good son. Everything above. My daddy had his days. Nobody's perfect, but he was perfect in all eyes. In any way it was, he looking out for anybody and doing whatever. I just going to do my part so he know that I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do and be a man as he want me to be and make him proud. I know it's very devastating. I wish I could share every moment with him, the future and everything else, but I just know he watching over me, my family. Into all of us, you know, yeah, it's in all of us now.
Right.
It's really in all of us now. And I love you, Pop.
I just wanted to say that I'm gonna love you always and I'm gonna miss you forever. I thank you for everything that you've done for me. You've been there ever since I met you. And I just wanna say thank you for that. I'm gonna miss your unique personality, your loving ways, and your laughter. You'll be missed always.
Some of the reasons why I am the man that I am today, and I went as far as athletics, is because of you. You were the first person to introduce me to sports. You're the first person that, in my eyes, that showed me dedication, that showed me what hard work was, no matter what your flaws were. In my eyes, you were always a good man. You always pushed me, and I strive for the best, and you were the reason why I am a successful person that I am today. And I was able to go to college on a full scholarship because of your dedication that you put into me, that you instilled into me, and to this day. And I will make sure that I promise you and to my kids that I will instill the work ethic and the dedication that you gave me and the confidence and the trust and the potential that you always told me that I had. I promise you that I'll withhold that and I'll carry that. Be a great father to my kids and make sure I give them 150% and make sure if there's another kid that's out there that I can give some of my knowledge that you instilled into me to them as well. I'm going to promise you that I'm going to live on and I'm going to carry that energy that you gave me. I'm still in disbelief because that I'm saying these things to you, but I want you to know that you are a major reason why I am the man and the person that I am today. I love you. Legacy will live on and it will live within me. And I promise you.
And this was for me. When I was growing up, that's who I looked up to, my brother. You know, I just miss him so much right now, and he just was a good mentor to me and to all of us, around all his friends. And I'm just really hurting right now. And I love my brother. You know, I love his children and all my nieces and nephews. He did the best he can, you know what I mean? And he always would take his shirt off his back and give it to anybody that was in need. And we can ask anybody, man. Chucky had a good heart. I learned that from him. I picked up trades from him. And he's gonna be greatly missed by all of us, man. And I'm just really hurt, you know what I mean? And I just wish the best for his children. And I just love my brother, man. I'm just still in shock right now. But like I said, man, Chuck did a lot of good things for people, man. And that's what made me pick up trades from him. You know, I try to help people if I can. And I learned it from Chuck, man, you know what I mean? It wasn't always good, but the good always the bad when I was with my brother, man. We talked all the time. We talked about the Lord all the time, you know what I mean? And we talked about the Bible, how he turned his life over to Jesus. And I was really proud of him, man, because he made me or do the same, you know, and we just encourage one another with the word of God. You know, he was good with that. And but like I said, he'd be greatly missed, you know what I mean? And I think about him every day. You know, I ain't gonna never stop thinking about my brother. But yeah, I get to the other side, and we all will rejoice together, man, and be happy together. I love you, Chuck, man. I love you, big brother. God bless you, God bless the family. Thank you.
I love this, my uncle, his humor. You know, my uncle was very nice, giving. I don't care what it is, I call him. We can be into it or whatever case may be. He's gonna come. I'm gonna miss him. You know, I love him. And I'm still sad, but I love my uncle, and I am gonna miss him. Everything about him.
All right, to my cousin Chuck, I wanna say thank you for everything you did for me, my mother, my brother, my sisters. Thank you for always providing a safe haven for us to always come to. I just remember the times when we ain't had nowhere to go, and I know we can come down. We ain't have to worry about nothing, no food, no nothing. We made sure everything was good. Thank you for always telling me. When I was a kid, I was bad. But you always told me, like, you gotta get out of that. You gotta do something better, do something different. I remember you always tell me, you still working at Burger King? So thank you for everything you did for us.
Okay, standing here, this was my Uncle Tom's celebration today, Uncle Chuck. I'm gonna miss you so much. When I was little, Uncle Chuck used to call me his favorite niece, even though he got a whole bunch of other ones. He always told me I was his favorite, because I was always black like him, he said. I love you, Uncle Chuck, and I'm gonna miss you so, so much. Calling me, telling me to cook you some fish, or just anything, just calling me. I can call you for any kind of ride, to do anything, and I love you, and I'm gonna miss you so much.
All right. I just want to express my condolences to the family. First of all, to my buddy Richard, like my little brother, to the rest of the family, Chucky. He meant a lot to me growing up. He opened doors for us growing up. He always believed in me. Father told me, hey man, you can always be better at everything you do. Hey, look at it now. I'm doing real good. I just want to say thanks to Chucky and my condolences to the family. Love you.
Me, Richard. I want to say thanks, Pops. Say you did everything. Have fun. Good times. I'm going to miss you.
I miss being at my sister's crib. And you picking me up. I remember you used to pick us up, me and my little brothers. Go to shovel snow at 2 in the morning. Cold as ever, I felt. But we did, and you was like a pops to me. Like, definitely going to miss you. The good times, the bad times. Every time I seen you, I always thought of your son. So.
I'm Mr. Lauren Ahmed, and I met Brother Chucky through my wife back in the 80s. And the first time she introduced me to her brother, we came here for vacation from school. I met my wife, Belinda, at Western Illinois University. And then when I came over here, she introduced me to Brother Chucky. And before we even get married, he's always saying, hey! You know, brother, ain't no the one, how are you doing? And every time when I come for vacation, like, you know, he always invite us for barbecuing. And he just talks so nice to us. He wants to go to places that we want to go to. And he's always out here. And I get to meet his little kids. Everybody that I have ever seen around him is always very happy. And I'm very happy with him. He's always calling me, even after we get married, we move to California. He's always calling us, and then when he speaks to his sister, he's always gonna say, let me talk to my brother-in-law. And I speak to him on the phone, I say, okay, I'm gonna come down here and get to bring you to California.
I'm praying and thank God for Chucky, my big brother, my oldest brother, for 63 years of life. God has been good. And I just got so many memories of my brother. I'm the baby, and he's the oldest brother, and he always spoiled me rotten, and always took care of me and came to my rescue on anything. And I'm gonna miss my brother so much. And I just wanna thank and praise God for his life. Thank you.
I'm gonna miss his smile, his laughter. I'm gonna miss talking to him three times a week to sometimes every day. I'm gonna miss just telling him about everything that's going on, just getting his point of view of things. Just listen to his isms, like how he just words stuff. it's a lot of them miss about me. I'm gonna just miss seeing my daddy. Like, be my daddy. We had a special relationship that I never, it'll never come to nobody else. I'm just gonna miss him. I'm definitely gonna miss him. I'm gonna miss everything about him.
The last conversation, anything he told you?
I know that he was at peace. He knew he was gonna pass. So I have peace in that, knowing that he knew. We just had a special bond that people just don't understand. So me being the firstborn, it's real. I don't have to discuss it, but I know. So doing the things I did for him, I know that that's what he wanted in his heart. And he wouldn't show up nobody else to do it but me. I'm gonna miss how he say my grandboys, or you know, how he say me, or just, he just had his way of words. I'm gonna miss being his daughter. I'm gonna miss that. How you say, come here! You know, it's just how he say stuff that you'll miss about me.